Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, scabs and scallywags to Let's Stream Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag. This is episode 20. And as we discussed at the end of the last episode, we're going to be spending time traveling some familiar water. It has been far too long in the playthrough, and we have not covered the first half of the map. So that is what we're going to do. But let's see how our fleet has been doing. Yes, we've been spending quite a bit of time in the wasteland recently, but it's good to be back in the West Indies. 5,000 reals. 5,200 reals. 34. Good. London. Wyatt Galley style bell. Huh, look at that. 621-277. Treasure map. The Royal Fortunes figurehead. Ooh. That's fantastic. How much money did that net us? $44,000. One moment. Is that enough for the guest house? Because yes, I will spend every real this crew gets if it means that my paradise mansion can be complete. Look at me back there, tripping on all my ambitions. Oh, It's kind of crazy that going back into a more historical setting has made me more relaxed than something a little bit less complicated like Fallout 3. Okay, here we go. Let's see.
Now what could I add to make it perfect?
That's it. The guest house. Wow. Look at that. A guest house has been built for the manor. Well, at least we got a multiplayer reward for it. New relic portrait emblem and title unlocked for the multiplayer. Well, as great as that is, at least we got an Abstergo challenge out of it. Which probably means we have a nice little statue. And nothing for the... No extra anything. Okay. Alright, well. We've done it. All the rest of the money that we ever make can go straight into the jackdaw. That almost killed us. I'm convinced that we would have died. Alright, let's return to the ship. All right, and let's go chase that horizon. Absolutely. And we're kind of wanted right now. I probably should have paid off her bounty. All right. Okay. There's a place. There's a place. Alright. We'll sail east, grab this chest, and then swing around.
Reef in, all top! Reef before foremen, haul in the topsails. As much sail as you can.
We ride the wind. Oh, a hunter. Great. Oh, fantastic. Okay.
Fire! Look, cabin! Put a shot right by her!
Cannon ready!
Trim the yards off the wind!
Do not leave us prisoner!
Move! Rest move.
Yeah. There we go. We'll kill the boarding crew. To be honest, the plan today is not to do this. But we might as well reduce our notoriety. There we go. Fantastic. Good way to start the stream. Some combat. Let's lower our wanted level, though.
I could use some good men.
Okay. Good deal. All right.
Foolish bones, take the shot.
He's off the wing. Haul it all sail. Clue up. Clue up.
We're ready, sir. Close down, cannons.
Fire.
All right, let's board. There we go. Easy as pie. There we go. We'll lower our wanted level.
Will he sign on, lads?
All right. And now,
we can improve the ship, Captain.
The ocean's our oyster. And we can get back to making more money. That. Nope. 3,000 reals. You know, maybe later. Okay. Okay. Oh, oh. There we are. Yes, he is. All right. Way to go. Loot. Nice. Yeah, I kind of wanted to ease back into the Assassin's Creed. We've reached 30 episodes in the Fallout playthrough, so I think I want to spend as much time as possible with Edward, because we did start this first. And, you know, I feel like we've neglected the story, the experience. Yeah. But I don't want to do that. So, we're going to have a lot of fun. A lot of good fun. And hopefully, that'll fund an expedition. Now, I think that we'll hit... Oh, we could go ahead and hit Black Island, but... well, we'll save some of those DLC islands for later. Alright. Here we are. This will be a nice little port of call. And eventually we'll have to start doing those Buccaneer missions. The Buccaneer or Privateer? I can't remember. Oh, I missed that by a mile. Are you kidding me? Oh, well. All right. Mary Guana Island. There's boar here, a viewpoint, four chests, two NMS fragments, and a secret. Well, I, for one, love secrets. Okay. Whoa. Oh, wow. It's a little close. Interesting. Hey, don't bump my boat. Oh my gosh, no. My ship? I really can't believe what I'm seeing. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh. Well, all right then. try not to think about that too much. Whew. Oh, look, a nice cadaver.
This is more like it.
This isn't where we are, is it? Nah. Okay, an animus fragment. We can always sell the hides or craft with them, which is, you know, great. Nothing will go to waste. All right, time to go back to the ship. Okay. Good deal. Now we go to Crooked Island.
Loose main sails!
Loose main sails! Man your ship!
Crowd on every inch of sail!
Close down! Man your ship!
Okay. And there we go. Yes, a little bit behind on the good old marathon, but we're coming back around for it. I'd like to make it to Rogue soon. Rogue's one of my favorites. All right, Crooked Island. Crooked Island. Well, let's head for higher ground and see exactly what this place has for us. Can't do the high leap. That's okay. There we go. So, some new things are popping up in the old rumor mill regarding Assassin's Creed while we're thinking about it. There are several titles rumored to be in development at the moment. I know that we know about Assassin's Creed Mirage. Very excited about that. We also know about Assassin's Creed Codename Red, which is supposed to be set in feudal Japan, and I heard something new today on Kinda Funny Games. Credit to Greg Miller for breaking it to me. Not personally, of course, but I'm a pretty big fan. Yes. What was I saying? I swear it was important. Oh, yes. Apparently, Codename Red will take place not only in feudal Japan, but will focus on two protagonists, much like Assassin's Creed Syndicate did. Which, is definitely grounds to talk whether you liked or disliked that game. And they better not be messing with my ship again. Let's see, what else do we have? 2 assassination contracts, quite a few chests. You have no complaints on that from me. Project Hexa is set to release in 2026. Now, Project Invicta is supposed to be... bringing back the Assassin's Creed multiplayer in some way. Either that's through Unity with the co-op objectives, or if it's through... German rapiers. Okay. I wonder how good those are. There's a weapon merchant somewhere around here. There he is. Excuse me. Let's see, probably nothing outstanding, since we've pretty much got some of the best swords in the game. Captain Drake's swords, which just look fantastic. German rapiers are even worse than that. Wow. Okay. That's fine. Pistol sets? No. Ammunition outfits? Maybe. The privateer outfit. Completely jet black, other than the pirate captain, which is black and red, you know. So. Oh, yes. Pieces of art. We can round out our art collection then, which is great. Project Jade, or I keep calling them projects, they're not projects. Codename Jade is a mobile game, which I wish was actually heading to the consoles, because it's set in China, which I think just looks fantastic. There was some leaked gameplay of it. Very Valhalla-esque. I won't lie. But hopefully they can make a balance between a hack and slash and a true Assassin's Creed experience. Because that, we just don't have enough of those anymore. This pot down here looks comically like one of Leonardo's tanks from far away. Okay. Then, if we jump here. Alright. There we go. We're really coming across the collectibles, which I'm pretty happy about. First reverie, we still don't have a number 2. Which is a shame. We have a tavern to break up, and then possibly some assassination contracts. I don't know if we'll do that. That's the first NPC lady that was fairly attractive that they've done this little dance with. Alright, that's fine. Have your friends pick you up. You can't stand on your own, because you're not a man. Oh, he wanted to punish me there. There we go. We won't mess with the assassination contracts. We'll do that in mass. En masse. Later on. Let's see. Animus fragments. Then we can go around here and grab these. We need to check out Jigwe as well. We need to stay away from that legendary ship, though. That's something we don't need.
How might I find your favor today?
Yeah, how might you find it? Okay, let's take a look here. The appearance is, okay, so we need 500 boards of wood. And then, oh yes, the ultimate set of cannons and then the elite set of cannons. Oh dear. We are going to need to build up our resources.
Perhaps enough.
Yeah, and we will. That we will. Yeah, that's right, boys. Let's sail. Yeah, let's sail here. We'll do this circle here, then we'll come in through here, grab all these. We might make this episode quite a bit longer, actually, just because, I don't know. I like to keep episodes roughly an hour in length so that people can come back and it's not one of those big slogs like I used to do. Foul weather? What do you mean? I don't see it at all.
Storm Captain, looks bad.
I must be blind. But yeah, when I first started this game, this marathon, I would do several hours. I would do milestones more than hours, and I really feel like my early videos really suffered for that. But oh, sorry, Ade. Woo. Yeah, he did. But yeah, did the same in Assassin's Creed 2. Finally, I started getting around the hour, hour and a half mark, which isn't too bad. I'm pretty comfortable with that now, and it's a shame that it took me that long to get to that point. And it changes the way I film, because if I know that I've got a big trek ahead of me, I don't know, it's like I settle in for the long haul, and I don't talk as much, unfortunately. Though, you know, you try commentating for 3 hours straight with not a whole lot going on in the chat. I used to have some pretty regular commenters, but, you know, I don't really get that much anymore. I'll actually sometimes finish a stream and then I'll look down. Oh, you know, there was somebody. I feel horrible. So if I've ever done that to you, I do apologize. I'm just not used to it. And I don't have a setup that really lets me do an overlay for chat. Though one of my good old friends, Ray Faraday, says often that I just need to get a face camera and get good. And I keep telling her I will, but I never do. I guess I'm comfortable. You know, I still have to bully her into coming back to streaming. And, of course, I don't really mean bully, but, you know, playfully encourage. All right.
Captain has the helm.
Thank you. And we'll come up here and do that Animus Fragment. We really should check our little figurine collection at Abstergo. That's one of the things I like the most about having Abstergo as the present day setting, the hub. I thought it was very fun. On this side. That's odd. But we got some rum. Twenty out of 30 Animus Fragments. Wow. Alright. There we go. Sorry, Ade. I sure do. And let's see. We'll head here.
Let out some sail.
Yeah. Turn around a ways. Then keep on making our way around.
Every last scrap of duck on the wind.
Kind of nice to have a little chill episode like this. You know, we're not doing a whole lot. You know, just enjoying the scenery because the game map is just fantastic. You know, I think that the only other one that I really appreciated even more than Black Flag was definitely not Rogue, because you'll see what I mean in Rogue. But Assassin's Creed Odyssey has a phenomenal ocean. The Grecian Isles are just, oh, it's unreal. Unreal. And I think that's a big reason why the game is so popular, even now. I mean, people destroyed that game for really turning it into, not really an Assassin's Creed title, but you know, it's the earliest point in the timeline. I understand that, you know, not even the Assassins can be that old. Assassin-like, maybe. But even the Templars didn't exist back then.
Storm there, Captain! Look bad!
Oh, we'll beat it. Okay. But, you know, it'd be a good, pretty good episode to just kind of talk about kind of where the channel's going. I've got a few of Let's Plays that are, they're in my channel. They're ongoing, but I haven't touched them in forever. I used to have a pretty big schedule, but, you know, it started getting too big. I wanted to do an Assassin's Creed game, a criminal-focused game, and then an RPG. But that was just too much. So I tried to supplement that with Doom. That didn't really work either. As much as I adore Doom for what it does, I'm not very into Doom. I'd probably have to be in the mood, be in the, you know, in the zone. So that's where Doom and Cyberpunk and Sleeping Dogs have been. The Mafia games are so short you can get through them in just a couple of episodes. So yeah, Sleeping Dogs and all of its DLC is a story I do want to go back through. I may restart them, honestly, and then just remove those videos from my channel and start fresh. I hate thinking about doing that, though, because, you know, if I start doing that, you know, then what incentive do you have to watch episodes if I'm just going to get cold on them and then delete them? So that's kind of where I'm at there. I may do a kind of like a hard recap or something like that, but I don't know. I also have to get myself back into the game, you know? Alright. We're doing pretty well. If we're looking at the map, at least, we started here, and we've done pretty much this entire little area. So now we just have to go westward, all the way to the end of the map, technically, but really, this is the core of it right here, which is not too bad. So this is our next stop here. We may go in there, I don't know, but Florida? Yeah. I want to stay away from Blackbeard if I can help it. So we'll probably hit this one, and then this one. Then go into over here for that as well. Kind of making our way around. So, what's really working for the channel right now? Well, probably the Assassin's Creed Marathon is something that I will absolutely finish. I can't not. And, you know, I may even add a sub-series where I go through all of the Assassin's Creed Chronicle games, because those are very cool. But I'm not very good at isometric, not really isometric, but 2D platformers. Just because I feel like I lack almost the depth for that, you know? Should we hunt a hammerhead? I think we should. Yeah, break up the monotony a little bit.
Ready, lads?
Ooh, okay.
The rope is holding! Off we go!
Okay.
It's a hit! Got you now, fish!
Oh, he'll get tired.
The sea dog's hit. He's on the rope. See anything yet?
Now, sharks freak me out.
He's headed this way. Starboard bow. The rope is holding. Here we go.
Ooh, all right. Ooh. All right. All right. Thank you.
Lose all and trim sharp to the wind.
All right, so that's not too far away. But yeah, what's going on? The Assassin's Creed Marathon is something I will do. It's a fantastic series, and I'm getting really excited about all that they're doing, especially Assassin's Creed Mirage, kind of going back to the roots of things, you know, back to the Altair and Ezio days. What else? Oh, so I don't really talk about it much, but I am actually an avid tabletop role-playing game GM. Maybe one day I'll be a player, but that's not today. And it seems as though Ubisoft is funding a tabletop adaptation for Assassin's Creed, which I assumed could be homebrewed with the Savage Worlds tabletop setting, just because it's so generic in scope that you could almost flavor. Oh. You can almost flavor anything that you didn't understand. For example, signature weapon for the Assassin's Blade. You could invent new traits for the kind of brotherhood that you come from as well. And it would just work. Not to sound too much like Todd Howard. But yeah, it just works. Fallout, and I'm hoping other Bethesda RPGs are proving very easy to film. Shout out to Gopher and Sorcerer Dave, and for the really long viewers, Jingles, for inspiring me to kind of do a roleplay series where, you know, I kind of step out of, you know, Jeff in a way. It's still very much me, especially with the character of Henry. Because, you know, I'm a naturally, you know, good moral person. Now, I can't wait to finish my first playthrough of Hogwarts Legacy, actually, because I'd love to bring that to the channel and kind of do that. I don't want to stream my first playthrough because that's mine. That's for me. I've named myself my real name, you know, everything. Everything that, you know, little 11-year-old, well, really, I was introduced to the franchise, oh, in probably 2000, 2001, so I was a little bit younger than 11, but really, what kid doesn't want to go to Hogwarts, you know? And raised in a Christian family, actually, I was very surprised to realize that my parents valued the differentiation between faith and fiction, which really allowed me to explore all sorts of stories that I wouldn't have ever been able to, you know, experience in a much more traditional situation, which I'm very grateful for. It's Harry Potter and the entire Wizarding World is actually one of the best ways that I can ever spend time with my own mother. Love Mom, but we're so alike. We need, like, a buffer, you know, to bond over. Very strong personalities, let's say. Oh. But yes, Fallout 3 is going very well. I enjoy the story. I enjoy thinking about things outside of a gamer's perspective. You know, when I made the decision to go ahead and capture Marie, that was actually very hard for me to put myself into Henry's perspective. You know, as much as he values family, what is the greatest good, you know?
We're headed straight for Lanza.
He's off the wind.
Okay, here we go. A smuggler's den. We've not done one of these before. How exciting. Wow. Okay. Let's check it out. 4 chests, 2 animus fragments, and a secret. Well, here's the secret. Which one's this? Is this number 2? No. Okay. Well, we'll find number 2 eventually. Wow. Look at that. Let's try to do this as stealthily as possible. Well, my friend, be careful.
Back and forth, and back and forth.
Yeah, and back and forth. Gotta be careful. You may fall. Sugar. Hey. Ah, come on then. There we go. But yeah, going back to what I was saying, you can find a lot of really interesting ways to play a Bethesda game. For example, I've got a second playthrough of Fallout 3 planned, in which I'm going to do significantly more selfish and conniving things. I may even do evil. Though I can never justify blowing up Megaton unless you're going to be just dastardly evil, like raging mustache, you know, might as well be Hitler kind of a guy.
I'm gonna pull that tongue right out of your skull.
And those aren't very fun characters to play.
I demand an apology.
Oh, come on, highlight both of them.
And how many old sons? Yeah. And I'll ask your mother.
There we go. This guy's gonna catch me on fire. All right. Not good. Fantastic.
Where are you going? Come back.
There we go. Ah, crap. Here he comes. Oh, no? Okay. That's fair. I suppose. That's gonna get me caught if I'm not careful.
Bastards down half our hold already. The bloody left hit us.
All right. Go us. All right, then we'll sail north for the fragment. We're doing pretty good. So the good karma playthrough is Henry, as we know him. Love him. Bless him. He's been having it rough. Then we're going to do a almost like a vault punk kind of a story. The character's proper name, or his full in-universe name in my own head, is Zeke the Freak. You know, naturally butting heads against Butch in the vault. He wanted to outdo him, and not for the greatest reasons. Wow, that's a ton of cash. Swag, if you will. Zeke, you know, he's practically James's disappointment. Where James is charismatic and scientific, Zeke is hard-headed and rough and tough, and he doesn't really care about using his head as long as he can use his hands to do it. Will he side with Mr. Burke regarding Megaton? I don't think so. He probably would think that Tenpenny Tower is way too... what would you call it? Clean.
Loose main sail.
That's a little bit too far to ignore the chest over here.
I know she's a good sailor. Now prove it, my trunks.
But yeah, after that, whoa! Wow. After that, of course, would be on the RPG front. I have 4 planned playthroughs of Fallout New Vegas. One from the perspective of an NCR playthrough, a Legion playthrough, a Mr. House playthrough, and then the Yes Man wild card playthrough. And each of them are as different as can be. The NCR playthrough is your typical, you know, patriotic soldier boy. He actually doesn't enlist because upon the events of the game, he's decided that he can do things that the NCR can't, because they need to save face. So he kind of becomes like a black op operative. His name is Sam. Then my Legion character's name is Pilot. He will be playing the fantasy of a slave who has forgotten his master. At the very beginning, Pilate is not going to realize that he's actually been a legionnaire courier for years. But as he gets closer to Benny, the mystery will... Really, the first moment where he realizes that he's not who he thinks he is probably when he sees the Legion atrocities in Nipton. And then, as we begin to get more and more comfortable with the Legion in that part of the game world, he'll realize that he is probably the closest thing to an ex-Frumentari that there is. But when he died, when he got shot in the head, he did lose all of that knowledge. So he's not really a Frumentari anymore, is he? And then there's Dr. Bizarre. Or Dr. Weird. I haven't settled on a name quite yet. But he is going to be loyal to Mr. House because Mr. House can pay for all of his experiments. Very typically the mad scientist kind of a character. He is wacky, zany. He will be using the Wild Wasteland trait. And Old World Blues will probably be the longest played area for Dr. Bizarre, Dr. Weird, whatever I decide. And he will help Mr. House in his schemes to take over the Mojave Wasteland for good. And for business. And for Mr. Bizarre, Dr. Bizarre, for science. And then there's the last character. For my Yes Man independent run. He is simply known as No One or Nobody. He won't have a name. And he will be very inspired by Arthur Morgan. If not a tad more ruthless than Morgan. Probably think Unforgiven, Clint Eastwood's film Unforgiven, meets Arthur Morgan. He's an old gunslinger. He will primarily use one-handed pistols, some handguns, specifically Lucky the Mysterious Magnum, A Light Shining in Darkness, and that gun. He'll be a criticals build. Definitely. And he will burn the Mojave down. Which is pretty fun. After Black Flag, we'll be following the Freedom Cry expansion for this game, which will be pretty interesting. I've not completed it. I've started it, but I've not completed it. So that's always fun. Now, we're probably going to need to come in around here and just go ahead and do this whole little section right here before coming down from the north and doing all of this. I think that's the best idea because we don't want to miss anything. Oh, man. Talker, Rick. Great. We won't be doing no diving today. That is for sure. Though, we might as well discover the fast travel point. Because we're going to have to do it eventually. Unfortunately. Let's see. Did we ever do that one that we had to do? Where was that? Yes. The San Ignacio wreck. We did that all. So if we can do that, we can 100% the rest of them.
Look here, sir. Something in depths below.
Yeah, look at that. We won't be doing that today. Yeah, I think we'll grab this chest here and cut the recording for this episode. I do want to keep it at about an hour length, you know, just to keep it uniform. we don't want to do hour-long, hour-and-a-half-long episodes, and then all of a sudden be 3 or 4 hour just honker. All right. There we go. All right. That'll be that. 10 out of 46 chests. It's insane. But if you're watching live, do stay tuned. I'm going to let my dog out and get back to recording. But this will be the end of this episode of Let's Stream Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. I'd like to thank everyone who tuned in live and everybody who's tuning in on YouTube after the fact. Oh, and where shall we go? Yes, howler monkeys. We actually need to go south. We can grab that when we actually do that mission. But we'll go northwest.
Get the veins free.
But to everybody watching later on YouTube, I also thank you for your view.
Crowd on every inch of sail.
If you enjoy what I do, please consider following me here on twitch.tv/JeffTheNarrator469. We recently made it to a milestone of 10 followers, which... You know, thank you all so much. You know, it's a small goal. It's a goal still, and that's a goal met. That's very encouraging. I'd like to get to 50 so I could possibly become an affiliate. You know, that kind of passive income, that secondary income would be life changing. But that's not really why I do this, though. It would be probably a dream come true. To be able to do something that I love for a living. Which is why I write and such like that, but I'm not ready to self-promote that bad. But if you prefer to watch a little bit more traditionally on YouTube, then please find me on YouTube at Jeff the Narrator. All three words, no numbers. Where I upload all the VODs that I record on Twitch daily. Not daily, but whenever I record on Twitch, within the next hour or so, I'd say that the episode will be up. Oh, yes. But that will be the end of this episode. Once again, thank you all for spending a little bit of your valuable time here on my channel. I love sharing stories with you guys. And hopefully, we'll have many more to share in the future. So, as Edward paddles his way over to the jackdaw, climbs and hoists himself up, we will stop this chapter of the story for now. But we'll be back sooner than you think. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much, and I hope that you have a great rest of your day and a great rest of your week. If you're starting your week, if you're in the middle of it, hey, that's okay, because the weekend's coming. And... as always, please, keep telling stories.